Doctor Who fans losing their mind right now. Do you feel pressure? Do you feel the pressure of being the new Doctor Who assistant?
I suppose at times, but I'm kind of I'm very removed from it really. I'm living in Cardiff and in a studio, and you kind of is easy to forget
they
about
make
the outside
you live
world.
Live in the studio. So you're filming it at the moment, is that right?
We're on a hiatus at the moment, so we're kind of prepping and finishing up, and we're in between.
Were you a Doctor Who fan before the series, or before you got the job?
Well, I was denied that pleasure as a child, because it came back in 2005, so I missed him. I missed that kind of time as a child, so I...
Good excuse. Someone's had media training.
Was it easier then, when you went for the audition, not, like, being aware of everything that you were getting into?
In a way, but there was quite a strange point where I felt like I was being followed by Matt. Because I kept seeing the Doctor, like, when I was on the tube, kind of, there'd be a poster and he was, like, pointing at me, or I was at the BBC and suddenly there was a life-size cutout of him, like, next to me, which is quite strange.
Or he was in the bushes with binoculars. Where did you find out? How did you find out?
Oh, it's really glamorous. I was in M&S.
Oh, yeah.
Holding an avocado. And then I got the call. literally,
in
I was
the food
like debating.
Department, presumably. Yeah, no, not big... in clothes, going.
Trying to find out where it goes. No, I was having a huge debate about what to have for dinner, and it was like, you know, I'm a big tune growing.
Yeah, and you'd come up with a rubbish answer.
And so, what, you got a phone call?
I got a phone call.
Yeah. And then what happened after you hung up from that phone call, knowing you are now the new Doctor Who assistant?
I was still holding the avocado, so I hung up and I just didn't know what else to do other than put it back.
And did you keep shopping?
No, well, that's the thing. I just kind of left my basket and kind of just
went
for a walk.
Have you ever been asked so many questions about having an avocado in your life? I don't know why I'm so obsessed.
I've always been interested by, like, a lot of kids are scared of Daleks, aren't they? But yeah. I've always thought they looked a little bit like upside down shuttlecocks. And it was just like, when I was a kid, I was scared of David Bowie and Labyrinth. And I was just wondering what scared you as a kid?
There's a guy, there's the guy.
There's
it's
a
like
guy.
A mini robot. It's a mini robot on Star Wars. Is it R2-D2? Yeah, and he's the friendly one, isn't he?
What?
Yeah. He used to terrify me.
Really?
Yeah.
And everyone else just thought C-3PO was a prick. He's a friendly one.
You're probably going to get to meet him now because of all the kind of comic book conventions and stuff.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, is that... Do you have to do all those, like, sci-fi conventions now?
I'm yet to do one, but I'm going to go to San Diego to go to Comic-Con this year.
Are you aware of what goes on there?
I've heard all sorts of...
What goes on there?
..wondrous stories about kind of, you know... It's basically everybody's chance to kind of go and be their own... their favourite superhero for the weekend. So, kind of, people turn up just as Spider-Man and Batman, and then, you know, Spider-Man and Batman can get together and, you know... You can kind of... All sorts of goings-on.
Fathers for Justice.
Fathers for Justice. Who are you going to go at?
I heard a story that Andrew got... That would be a good one. I need a mask, see? A mask would be better. I heard Andrew Garfield went as Spider-Man, and he could actually, like, go around the crowds and walk and kind of experience for himself because he had the mask and nobody knew it was actually him.
So the guy that played Spider-Man in the movie dressed up as Spider-Man at a sci-fi convention.
Yeah.
Come on, mate, have a day off.
Now, you spent some time in Hollywood, and I read somewhere that you actually auditioned for a role in which you were going to play an Australian and had to adopt an Australian accent.
Yeah.
Is that how... what's your Australian accent like?
I didn't get the part, can I just say? I just say that before we start.
There's the man that got the part.
Yeah. And also, my two Australian cousins are in the audience, probably slightly mortified right now. But I had a line which was, that crake is as dry as a dead dingo's donga.
So it's quite a good sitcom, then.
That was amazing. It was like being home all of a sudden. Have you got a Doctor Who doll? Is that next?
I'm yet to see it, but I had to go in a machine. I had to get scanned and kind of basically like all these lasers, and you have to stand really still and you get miniaturized. But it's quite difficult because you have to really think about what expression you want.
Like the fly. What's good? So what? And then they come out and there's two of you, big you and a doll.
I haven't seen it yet, but, you know, it's the kind of... You have to stay still for a really long time, and I just remember feeling the pressure of what expression do I want my doll to have.
So what did you go for?
I kind of went for, like, action girl, you know, kind of... But a bit friendly, too.
Yeah.
That was what I was going for.
Wow. I'm not going to buy it.